Hi everyone, it's Dr. Sarah Moore here, and I have the pleasure of being with Mish Pope today. So Mish is a life coach, she is a public speaker and also a podcaster, and I'm delighted to be speaking with you today, Mish. So welcome.
Thank you, Sarah. I'm excited to be here as well.
It's really exciting. So, Mish, we're going to talk a little bit about your involvement with the Southwest Wellness Festival this year. And so I just thought we could begin by talking about why it is that you are involved and what you're looking forward to the most about the festival this year.
Yeah, well, I'm involved this year because I feel really passionate about helping people reduce kind of what I call like the cage bird syndrome, where we kind of lived in these trapped lives where we're not living to our fullest potential and we're not living as aligned lives as we want to. But I'm also really passionate about giving practical tips on how to like kick burnout, exhaustion, just things that everyday people can use, because I know our lives are busy. We've got lots going on, but so many of us, I think, are kind of living a monotone life where we're not really know if we're super aligned or if we are really living in a way that we want to live. So that's why I'm super excited. And I love this idea of kind of mixing both Western, allopathic, Eastern, all sorts of philosophies all into one, so that people can really be proactive in their both physical, spiritual, and mental health. So I'm really honored to be part of it, actually.
Wonderful. Well, we are delighted that you are involved. So Mish, can you tell us a little bit about what you will be doing at the festival this year and how people can connect with you on festival day?
Yeah, so I'll have a stall. I think I'm going to have it staffed by my husband as well, which will be interesting and fun for him. Yeah. But I'm going to be just having some tips and some things for you people to take home. And I'll be talking more about my life coaching packages, if people want to talk about those, upcoming workshops that I've got. But most importantly, I'm doing a talk on a really simple way to like understand the difference between burnout and overwhelm, how to kind of kick the glorification of busy. I mean, how often is it, Sarah, that we ask someone, so how are you doing? They're like, oh, I'm so busy. I'm so busy. And is that what you really want? And what does that look like? And the importance of boundaries and really simple tips. So I'm excited to share those. And it'll be for everyone because I think it's applicable for everyone.
Great. Well, I'm sure there's lots of people watching that will be lining up to hear you talk about that, Mish. And so finally, Mish, would you like to share with us your top tips for staying well?
Yeah. So, I mean, there's always the cliche stuff, right? Like eat well, sleep, and, you know, make sure you drink water. But I want to give you four tips I think are really pertinent to kind of my zone of genius, which is the first one is that everything happens in seasons. And sometimes we have seasons of spring, sometimes metaphorically speaking, sometimes we have seasons of winter. And honoring those seasons is really important. I saw a statistic, I heard a statistic recently somewhere around that 60 to 80% of the doctor's visits that you would see almost, Sarah, would be stress related at some aspect. And for me, that's just not living in your season, in your own rhythm. The second would be is to ask for what you need. So to ask for what you need in your relationship, to ask what you need in your employment, to be courageous enough and vulnerable enough to say, I actually need this from you, or I need this space or this time, or this type of love, or whatever it is, to be able to ask for what you need. The third is to learn how to say no. It's a pretty simple word. It's just two, which is N-O. But you'd be surprised at how, I mean, we've talked about that before, of being very diligent about saying no so that you can say yeses to the things you actually want to say yes to. And the fourth thing that I would say that I'd love to talk about for health and wellness is cultivating a relationship with restorative joy. So not just like rest where you, you know, sit in bed and watch Netflix, which is totally fine because there's some amazing stuff on Netflix. But it's also about, understanding what brings you energy, like what recharges your battery. And so I call that restoration, or being able to restore and cultivating a relationship which brings joy, which I think a lot of us don't understand anymore. I'll often ask people, well, what brings you joy? And there's kind of like radio silence. Because we've forgotten, especially as women, to nourish ourselves in a really restorative way. because we're either scrolling on Facebook or Instagram to try to avoid the dishes and laundry that need to be done, or we're just flopping into bed at, you know, 11 o'clock at night after a huge day. So figuring out how to restore ourselves and bring a relationship of joy is one of my biggest passions, especially for women.
Wow, that sounds beautiful. And I'm so glad that you've shared those tips with us today. And I'm sure that'll resonate with many of the people watching. So yes, it's going to be a great festival day, Mish. Yes. And I'm really pleased that you'll be there. Just to remind everyone, it's going to be Sunday the 28th of October, starting at 8:30 in the morning and finishing up at 2 in the afternoon. And we'll be on Queen Street in the Busselton Cultural Precinct in Busselton. And it's a free event, so please bring along friends and family. And we look forward to seeing you there. Thanks very much.
Awesome. You too. You're welcome.
All right then. See ya.